And it's 7, Chica and me. I mean, this was just a meme for me, in all honesty. This is just a number for me. I mean, to go back to the Tastiest Animatronics video, that video was all for me to make a joke about how toy Chica was tasty. People have drawn fan art where I am posing with Chica on my lap. I make countless jokes about how Chica and I are the only true FNAF ship that you should be shipping, and it's true. Chica and me is one of the most iconic FNAF memes for me. This is like the best meme in my mind, because Chica's my girl, okay? So stay away. Eddie VR, back up, alright? Chica's mine. You can have Roxy. I don't care about Roxy. You can have Roxy. Okay, fight for her with Juicy or something, cause like, Chica is the only robotic female who wants me, and I'm not giving that up! Screw what I wrote in the script, it's not happening!
Number 5, yoga. Or, if it's Twister, maybe you are doing it right. This meme features Mangle from the game, who finds themselves in a generally odd position on the ground, all tangled up with limbs all which ways. As Mangle do. But this picture being shown in the meme, it implies that this is simply Mangle doing yoga really badly. The words read, yoga, you're doing it wrong. And although your is spelled incorrectly, it should be Y-O-U apostrophe R-E, as in you are your, I was willing to let that slide because it made me laugh so hard. As I said, the other caption for this meme could explain that Mangle is actually instead killing it at the game Twister. That would be a funny counter meme, I think, to this one.
And at 4, Twisted Ones, pop figures. Don't get me wrong, I love pop figures, but I get pops about series that don't have things that want to kill me because they were killed in a children's pizzeria and then got stuffed into an animatronic suit, then possessed them in order to enact revenge on the one who put them there, but when they think that they've done it, he dismantles them and melts them down into soul-infused metal that gives his son a new life with the life that he took away from those kids. Essentially, why would I want murderous animatronic animals to be sitting on my shelf waiting for me to fall asleep so that they can get the chance to finish what they couldn't in the game? The Golden Fredbear plush I'd understand because, you know, he's here, he's there, he's everywhere. But the scariest pop figures of them all are for sure from the novel The Twisted Ones. These animatronics are meant to capture kids using sound illusion discs that make them look amazing, when in reality, they're terrifying and horrific. They bury themselves during the day and at night they come out and hunt for prey. Nocturnal, horrific monster animatronics that want to eat kids? I don't freaking think so. How on earth am I supposed to be cool with me putting these on my shelf, even if I leave it in the box? Yeah, that's right, I take my pops out of the box because I don't care about the value if I'm not gonna sell them. Right now I only have like 3 still left in the box, and that's out of at least 55 pop figures right now. The golden Doctor Strange, since the fans voted that he'd be made gold, so that's probably gonna be worth a lot. And the 2 paintable Bob Rosses from the last Fan Expo Canada. And so help me, if this one gets canceled, I'm gonna riot. They already canceled Comic-Con on me. Don't do it to Fan Expo. Don't do me that dirty. Or don't do me dirty with Fan Expo. Don't do me that dirty, sounds weird. And at 3, FNAF Endgame. I don't know what I can say to describe this without using every curse word in English and French. And in French, there's just literally a sentence that's just a string of curse words that means extreme anger. Thanos is one scary dude. Sure, he may not look like it, but he has literally wiped out half the universe at one point. He's inevitable. Eh. But Toy Thanos is one of the most haunting things I have ever seen and it will haunt my nightmares for the rest of my life. Thanos with a segmented face that he can remove at will in the style of Baby or Ballora is the scariest thing in the Marvel Universe. And if this ever actually became canon, I would just let myself perish. If the many worlds theory is true, there is one universe where this is canon to both the FNAF universe and the MCU, which is terrifying. But there is also another universe where this thing exists in our real world and we are being subjected to deal with him every single day. I'm dead in that universe, I'm just saying. And at 2, Mexican jumbo animatronic Twisted Golden Freddy 9 Five Nights at Freddy's exclamation mark. The title is long as hell because that is what the actual eBay listing is called and I'm not changing it. If you hadn't been scared by anything on this list, prepare to change your mind. This action figure is one of the worst things I've ever seen in my entire existence. Golden Nightmare Fredbear, but he removed the top 3/4 of his face like Withered Bonnie. Has growths of some sort of substance all over him, has 3 sets of teeth in his torn stomach, 2 of which are bottom rows, and has a Nightmare Bonnie puppet with its own like separated in the middle second jaw. Sure, you can put its face back, but that doesn't make it any better. And why does it need to be listed as Mexican? Like, what about this makes it required? I see no stereotypes associated with this. Oh, it's just that the seller is based in Mexico. I mean, like, why put that at the beginning of the title, though? We can see where it's coming from. Oh geez, Rick. And there's the link to prove it. Mexican Jumbo Animatronic Twisted Golden Freddy 9 FNAF 5 Nights at Freddy's. And that has a space and an exclamation mark. Like, why put the space and the exclamation mark? Just move it back one. Like, the item ID for this is shorter. God. Finally, in at number one, Mexican Animatronic Twisted Spring Trap Figure 8 FNAF 5 Nights at Freddy's Lightning Bolt, Lightning Bolt, Lightning Bolt. Holy ever-loving heck. This is one of the most terrifying things I have ever seen curse my eyeball since I walked in on my aunt Denise and my great aunt Harriet. This is not only horrifying, but inaccurate. While sure, the face being shown could be Afton's because we don't know what he looks like aside from a shadow of purple, why is his head spreadbare? Springtrap is a golden springlock Bonnie, so why is the head for the twisted springtrap Freddy? Sure, the twisted animatronics are twisted, but there's no way even Scott would throw that much of a curveball like this into the game, books, or hell, even FNAF World, and we all know what FNAF World really was. Oh, never mind again. Turns out that I'm just a dingus because I didn't scroll through the pictures, and turns out I'm wrong. It is Bonnie's head. In at 10, Sky Daddy Scott. Yeah, this is at the top of the list because frankly, this isn't really a meme in the FNAF community. More like just on this channel, okay? But during the pandemic, I started referring to Scott Cawthon as Sky Daddy Scott, since he was in essence the god of FNAF, being, you know, the creator and all that. But this started one random video when I asked him to actually let me help out in making a real FNAF, and I did address him as Sky Daddy Scott. There's not much else to it. but since then, I've used it many more times. There's not really much else to discuss about the topic. But yeah, Sky Daddy Scott, please put me in the FNAF movie at some point, or even like just as a reference, because I've suffered a lot for this series. Or maybe not, because apparently we're known for getting people mad over the top 10 worst FNAF fan games video, which was very clearly a joke. Like, I don't know why you people are gonna take us seriously after we made the top 10 tastiest FNAF animatronics. This whole channel is basically a comedy channel now, okay? These are all jokes. This video is also a joke. Like, we're not serious. God. I'm gonna make another one of those videos, but then put everyone's favorite fan games. In at 9, vent Gregory. Gregory, do you see that small vent on the floor? Have you heard of Among Us, Gregory? You need to vent. I know it will be hard for you to be sus, but I know you can do it, Gregory. This meme was all over the fanverse internet over the time, or like after the time when Security Breach had just released and it was kind of resurged when it was coming out on Xbox. The instance this is revolving around is obviously when you're in the like the stage section of the game where you're guiding Freddy through the doors after he gets his second wind. When Roxy and Monty are pounding on the doors and you can like shock them with the buttons, and then Vanny's watching you and you have a timer, yeah. To get out of that room, Freddy makes his way to a vent beneath you and then tells you to jump in once he pulls the grate off, which in the scene where this meme generates from, obviously. The joke comes from the venting mechanic in Among Us that only imposters could do, which is why the term sus was repopularized when the game went big over in November of 2020, despite the game releasing in 2018. I remember that very well. We were all about Among Us at that point. We even took a break from FNAF to do it, so. Yeah. In at 8, Docco Meme Review. Docco's meme review is, oddly enough, a meme within itself. For the purposes of this video, let's talk about some of the memes that have come from Docco, like the YouTuber. On September 16th, 2020, while he was watching a live stream for PlayStation 5, he was shocked that a trailer of the new FNAF game Security Breach was finally out. At first, Docco didn't actually believe that it was FNAF, even though it was literally an official PlayStation event, until he saw a cutout of Monty, one of the, you know who Monty is. After seeing the cutout, he overreacted for almost a minute and then actually ended up almost fainting. After this reaction, memes started to trend about his eccentricness. Docco also ended up getting into a friendly competition with Scott Cawthon. The two made a bet for where if he played 50-20 mode in Ultimate Custom Night and gave up, he would have to make a game called FNAF 5 where he praises Scott and goes on about how great he is. If Docco won, however, he would have won an interview with Scott Cawthon, and for several weeks, Docco painstakingly streamed 50-20 mode only to constantly fail. However, on July 8th, 2018, Docco managed to successfully beat 50-20 mode, and upon hitting 6 a.m., he broke down screaming and crying with joy live on stream. Sometime later, Docco got his interview with Scott, and then this is where the whole, like, we know that FNAF 3 was supposed to be the end thing happened. In at 6, FNAF World. FNAF World is an indie role-playing video game created by Scott Cawthon, and it was the first official spin-off of the Five Nights at Freddy's series, and the first RPG in the series, and the fifth game overall, although we ignore it now. The game was released for Microsoft Windows on January 21st, 2016, and on Android on January 12th, 2017, but came with unfinished gameplay and a large amount of bugs. Huh, wonder what that's like. Huh. Leading to a bad reception overall and ultimately the decision to remove the game from digital storefronts. On February 8th, 2016, the game was updated and re-released on Game Jolt free of charge. But despite the re-release, the community still ultimately wiped this game from memory, resulting in it living in infamy amongst the FNAF canon. And while the game is written off by most fans, its secret story mode actually puts the pieces in place for us to find the clues in FNAF 3 that unlock the good ending. So, I guess FNAF World is still kinda canon, but this is still seen as a meme and something that most of the community, including Scott, wants to forget about. Halfway through at number 5, jump scares. Specifically, Funtime Foxy has been getting a lot of love with the jump scare memes, mostly acting as an outraged mom, seeing a dirty room when you're having people over for dinner, when the dinner is for some reason in your room. Or me when I see anyone who looks remotely like my 12th grade comm tech teacher. Oh boy, that's a long story. I won't get into that one though. Along with the to be continued meme, I'm surprised I haven't seen any of the wasted memes out there, but I guess that's a little too on the nose. Anything with a face that can remove itself is fair game for this meme, and while it may not be as scary as the actual jump scare, we all know the feeling we get when we're under the blanket buck nude and your mother is charging up the stairs to asking you why you're not down for dinner. Okay, I don't. My mom never made dinner. She ordered it. She never made it though. My dad did. Again, long story. But like, Foxy, why are you hiding in the closet, man? Come out. This is an accepting space. In at 4, you're supposed to be on lockdown. Personally, I think this is like my favorite of the FNAF memes, and one that reached a more mainstream audience than the other ones thanks to the TikTok algorithm. But unfortunately, despite never having talked about FNAF on my TikTok until this point, I still had to deal with this scene from Security Breach where Gregory hides in the med booth while Vanessa yells at Freddy. The meme, however, comes from what Freddy says after Vanessa tells him that he should be on lockdown. They go from screaming, "Vanessa!" to, "But Vanessa, I'm a material girl," and everything in between. And yes, I did end up making a couple myself. My favorite one being, Officer Vanessa, I was just looking up Chica Rule 34. Because let's be honest, if it exists in this world, there is almost certainly art for it in the FNAF universe as well. Hell, there's probably someone on Etsy making like a Chica themed flashlight. And yes, I said flashlight, like as in one for illuminating dark areas, you nasties, and the other one. But you know what, in reality, the meme still isn't entirely dead, since the whole Vanessa one pops up on my For You page every now and then, and you know what, it's kind of annoying. No, it's very annoying.
Number 3, they said, this famous meme features the photo of the girl looking oddly mischievous as a house burns down in the background. What is really going on in this picture? Does anyone actually know? Is there an answer to this meme? This specific meme's caption poses the theory that this little girl was actually dealing with some FNAF haters. It reads, "They said FNAF sucks. Warning of what happens to haters of the franchise." Of course, I hope no one would actually go far enough to burn down someone's house because of an opinion. But still, the idea that this little girl was that hardcore in her love of FNAF is pretty comical. Especially because there are actually so many passionate fans of FNAF who are often so triggered when others talk even remotely badly about the games. Or even when fellow gamers accidentally call Chica Yellow Ducky. Triggered.
But ultimately, in at number 2, I Always Come Back. I Always Come Back was really a meme before the line was even uttered in the series. First being introduced in FNAF 3's trailer with the line, "If he will come back, he always does," and then getting the now iconic line of "I always come back" in FNAF Ultimate Custom Night. Brain Trap or Scrap Trap or Burn Trap or whatever trap, he will end up returning at some point or another. And while the meme is frustratingly accurate, I want it to stop, okay? I've said multiple times how he needs to stop coming back and just actually die. It's like the games are a toxic ex and will just for some reason can't stay away because he's getting lonely. But then again, that's what Beloro was for, I suppose. I want Afton to die and stay dead for good, okay? I've expressed this in countless videos, and like, I feel like a rich mother who's donated to a school that she wants her son to get into, okay? I've made so many FNAF videos that I feel like maybe I should have some input. Like, just kill him off and let me be a simp over the baddie Vanny, please. And finally, in at number one, you knew it was coming, Buff Helpy. This meme created by Thominius underscore on Twitter is just absolutely cursed. Buff Helpy was made for Docco's Five Nights at Freddy's meme review series and first appeared in episode 2. And since then, it is like, oh god. He made a joke in the video where he pretends to be terrified of it, and then people started sending him tons of memes about Buff Helpy, and it only has since spread from there, leading to Buff Helpy even getting his own spin-off game. Yeah. He even has his own Urban Dictionary page that labels him as a, let's say, traitor to his country who loves stalking the YouTuber Docco and somehow always makes his way into Docco's FNAF meme reviews, followed by the use of the term in Buff Helpy is best boy. And this entire thing was posted by Buff Helpy enthusiast. And you know what? Buff Helpy has also haunted me. I hadn't seen any Docco meme reviews, okay? So I was luckily oblivious to this meme. However, people just started randomly sending it to me on Instagram, and since then, it's kind of scared me. It's certainly better than what some other people have been sending me, but I mean, like, it's not the best thing I've been sent either.
Number 10, springtime. This meme is both scary and funny. It features Spring Trap peeking around the corner at you and reads, "Spring is just around the corner." Kind of some dark humor, with this one being a play on words referring to a phrase typically used revolving the changing of seasons from winter to spring, usually a positive thing, while mashing it up with the coming of a spring type animatronic on its way to kill you. But honestly, just the reference to Spring Trap here made me laugh. Definitely one fans of the franchise will enjoy and understand. Number 9. FNAF playthrough. This meme features popular YouTuber and gamer Markiplier, who has played through every FNAF game on his channel before. He has a playlist with over 80 videos that are all about his own journey playing through and experiencing the games. Having over 25 million fans and subs on his channel, it's understandable that fans have enjoyed watching him play the games so much that they would likely be entertained watching him doing it all over again a second time, returning to Freddy's. But of course, Mark has likely played and suffered enough through all those terrifying jump scares. And this meme references those very moments he has been caught in playthroughs being freaked the heck out, and alludes to the fact that Mark likely won't be revisiting the games anytime soon when it comes to making even more playthrough videos featuring FNAF titles he has already played. So much nope. Number 8. Most hated. One meme that I found to be very true is this one featuring Balloon Boy. It shows a picture of Balloon Boy and reads, "The only animatronic who can't kill you, still the most hated." Referring to the fact that Balloon Boy never directly attacks the player, but instead will mess with the effectiveness of their equipment in the game, messing up the player's attempts to defend themselves against oncoming threats, which usually results in their death. Balloon Boy also frustratingly mocks you all the while with his laughter. It's like he enjoys frustrating you.
And it's 7, Foxy Go Go Go. The original FNAF meme. You know that when Foxy's girl tells him her parents are out of service that he's running over 3 times as fast as he runs to your office. He's a simple man, just requiring near constant attention in order to feel comfortable. But I mean, don't we all? But no matter the context, having these private thoughts materialized in that meme where Foxy is swiggity swooty coming for that booty is too much. This, in all honesty, was the birth of the FNAF 34. This, in all honesty, was the birth of FNAF Rule 34. It doesn't matter how dummy thick Chica is, or how Ballora makes you feel while you're chilling with the blazes down in the Nether region. People wanting to see Foxy coming for their booty is one of the worst things I think mankind has ever done. Screw all the other incidents we've had over the past millennia. This is the ultimate crime. Screw ultimate custom night. Try ultimate prison sentence. Hell, even ultimate execution date. Causing this to form will damn your soul to hell quicker than I can eat it. That's a fact.
Number 6, least popular animatronic. A couple of the most well-loved animatronics in the game are Foxy and Bonnie. Heck, even Chica gets a lot of love from the fans. But you know who most people don't list as being their favorite? Freddy, the animatronic who is named in almost every title and is known as being the star of Freddy Fazbear's. I mean, his name is right in the restaurant title, and yet fans of the franchise prefer almost every other animatronic above him. Even fellow bears like Golden Freddy and Fredbear get more love than Freddy Fazbear himself. Hence why this meme is so funny, because it is just so true. This meme features a Freddy looking a little suspicious, but also a little sad. It accurately describes Freddy with its words. In the title of every FNAF game, still nobody's favorite.
And at 5, the fan shirt. The most terrifying thing in any of the FNAF games is the inevitable fan that is always blasting you with cold air while you sweat your nuts off hiding from animatronics. It was probably meant to provide ambient noise so you're not sitting there in complete silence while you hear the faint laughs and chuckles of animatronics in the distance. It's supposed to be gargles, but I said chuckles. Whatever. But the combination of it and that damn light bulb just end up making things much more intense. Like, what is that noise? Where is it coming from? Oh, it's just that godforsaken fan in the background. And now people are putting it on shirts and selling it to people for them to wear on their bodies? Why would you put this thing anywhere near your heart? The next thing you know, it's gonna be crawling into your chest cavity and laying eggs. Or it will just start chipping away like a lawnmower. Yeah, that's what lawnmowers are, just a giant metal fan that will cut anything it comes in contact with that isn't a rock. You know what rocks break? Bones. You know what bones won't break? A rock. A lawnmower will cut your hand clean off like some Final Destination sh**. And this fan will do that to your chest so fast you'll be crying for Freddy Fazbear to come rescue your ass.
Number 4. Notice me. This meme is a reference to the common archetype in anime, the girl who always wants the older boy, master, or her teacher to notice her, whom she usually also has a crush on. It features Chika looking through the window at you with the caption, "Notice me, senpai." If you are both a FNAF fan and anime fan, the use of Chica's wide stare in this way will likely leave you incapacitated, rolling on the floor with laughter. I wish I could say more to explain just why it's so funny, but honestly, it just is. If you were senpai, would you notice Chica? I don't see how you couldn't. Those eyes.
Getting close to the end, and number 3, the man behind the slaughter. The man behind the slaughter refers to a series of iconic memes referencing a line from a fan-made Five Nights at Freddy's song "It's Been So Long" by The Living Tombstones. The line of the man behind the slaughter describes the main antagonist of the series, William Afton, you know, the purple guy? Yeah. With memes referencing the character in one way or another, often by including the line in the caption as backup vocals. On December 4th, 2014, the Israeli YouTube musician The Living Tombstone released a single based off the plot of FNAF 2, where the chorus of the song references the main antagonist, known as the Purple Guy, describing him as the man behind the slaughter. The video received over 92 million views in 6 years, but with the song now having 214 million views in 8 years. Although I will admit that they still have the description labeling the FNAF series as Scott Cawthorn's creation and not Scott Cawthon's, but oh well. I've even had my own version of this meme where I posted a picture to my Instagram story of myself holding a blank piece of paper and smiling, and someone on that piece of paper put the man behind your daughter. I've never been prouder, honestly. That was like that won that meme Monday or whatever it was. Should I do more of that? That was funny. I should do more.
Number 2, Pirate Cove. There are a few memes that revisit some of the in-game scenarios where things can go sideways if you are not being diligent enough while playing. Two of the main times this happens in the game that fans like to focus on in their memes seems to be forgetting to wind up the music box, thereby waking up the puppet, and not paying enough attention to Foxy. This meme focuses on the latter and features SpongeBob and Patrick discussing how they forgot to check on Pirate Cove, with the next panel of the meme showing Foxy popping up behind them. The thing that really makes this one funny is the fact that, of course, Patrick and SpongeBob also are just dressed up as pirates in it. It's like a little pirate party once Foxy also pops up. Maybe a pirate murder party. Or, you know, maybe Foxy would spare them because they're dressed like pirates too. Maybe that's a good way to protect yourself from Foxy, just dress like a pirate. Number 1, storyline. There are also a few memes that center around the fact that the storyline of FNAF is somewhat convoluted, and that the franchise has obviously blown up beyond what Scott Cawthon perhaps originally anticipated, becoming a whole world of its own, full of lore, secrets, and mysteries yet to be uncovered. This meme is also created with images from SpongeBob. In this meme, SpongeBob attempts to explain what the header describes as the FNAF storyline. It's not as simple as a three-sided triangle or a four-sided square, but is so complex it's just a series of dotted lines making up an undefinable blob of a shape. And I mean, I think that that is hilariously accurate, as it feels like every game or book for FNAF adds another layer to the already twisty-turny, confusing story of FNAF's kind of behind-the-scenes style plot. I mean, that's also what we love about it, but I think it's fun to acknowledge just how crazy it's gotten.
In at 10, Peppa Pig. Peppa, what are you doing in my FNAF game? For some reason, people love inserting Peppa into scary things in general, like scary games or scary movies. But for some reason, Peppa in FNAF is just worse than all the others. Is it like an actual thing though? Did someone mod the game to add Peppa? Is modding FNAF really a thing? I know that like modding Custom Night is, or at least I think it is, but like, does that mean that we could mod Help Wanted? Because if we could get a Peppa Pig roller coaster where I can shoot Peppa in the face with like a million balls, I would be very pleased and excited to try it. If we can find any form of like Peppa Pig FNAF VR mod, I might play it again willingly, but I'm only playing the real thing again if we end up getting more views and likes on that video, so go keep watching me freak out and like that vid if you want more of me freaking out. But I will hands down play it again if we can get a Peppa Pig mod. No cap. And at 9, vents. Security cameras and vents only make sense in FNAF games. Why else would you put a security camera in a vent unless there's the potential of a freaking naked endoskeleton or some other form of animatronic or human in an animatronic suit coming through and attacking, killing, or stuffing you in a suit? My question is, why can't you just block the doors or something? Why does it require power to drop the doors down when that would just require less power? Like, what? No matter, whenever a character ends up in a vent, they always get put in some weird situation or position, and it makes for some interesting and rather spooky memes, especially the damn endoskeleton man. I can't with this thing. Imagine if these were Peppa Pig, I wouldn't be able to handle myself or my bladder. It would either be the scariest damn thing on the planet or the funniest. Can you imagine like a nightmare Peppa? Dear Lord, that would be terrifying. I honestly don't know why I'm so stuck on this whole Peppa thing. Peppa. And it ain't Miley Cyrus Chica. The only thing scarier than FNAF is Miley Cyrus. Okay, not really, but it's still not pleasant to be reminded about how blurred the lines can get. Look, I've done my fair share of photoshopping over the years, even getting into a Photoshop war with a friend. I only photoshopped him once because that's all I needed, because I put his head on Miley Cyrus while she was twerking on Robin Thicke. But making that same modification to Chica has to be one of the most unholy things that has ever been done on this damn planet. I don't need Miley on Chica, especially when you change her bib from Let's Eat to Let's Twerk. Honestly, is nothing protected anymore? I can't handle this! How on Cawthon's green yet surprisingly bloody earth am I supposed to be okay with Miley Cyrus on Chica? The shadow isn't even right for God's sake. It's not even that hard to do, just make another layer with the face, crank up the contrast, turn down the brightness, and then change the opacity and boom, you have a proper shadow. I mean, you also gotta move the layer, obviously, but like, you know what I mean. Look at that, Photoshop tutorials in a top 10, you're welcome.
Number 7, No No Foxy. This meme features Gru from the Despicable Me franchise, but is a nod to that sigh of relief you experience in FNAF when you have successfully managed to close the door in time before Foxy can run into the office. It's funny because it accurately sums up that feeling you have whenever you stop an animatronic. That nah-uh-uh, you can't come in moment of triumph. That I got you moment. I stopped you. This feeling is heightened too when it comes to stopping Foxy, as he doesn't just slowly creep up on you, but has a tendency to sprint towards you once out of Pirate Cove. The meme syncs up the perfect taunting reaction of Gru to that moment when you close the door on Foxy.
And it's 6, security camera. The scariest part of the game are the jump scares, and even if you don't think that the game is scary, most of us didn't spend all of our time playing FNAF. We played dating simulators on the DL trying to learn how to get girls. I don't actually think I've ever played a dating simulator, in all honesty. But I'm open to it, as long as it's like that KFC one, cause like, oh yeah, I want Sanders' Big Bucket. That was meant to sound weird. I actually did use FNAF to try to get a girl though. That's a long story. Should I tell it? Might as well. In grade 10, I had the first game downloaded due to research purposes for an assignment, and I started playing it on the bus after one of the new girls had sat next to me because I wanted to seem cool by playing video games on a bus. It was stupid, and it obviously didn't work. Jesus. Oh. Man, I'm cringy. Sorry, got off track. One of the best moments in these games is when you open your tablet and see a giant freaking face in front of the lens. So, of course, it got turned into a meme, from Bonnie shoving her head in your face at the store, to even understanding why there's cameras in the vents. This is why. It's definitely more of a funny meme than a scary one, but there are for sure some scary ones out there. Just Bonnie's face is just... Ah. Halfway through into number 5, Swiggity Swooty. Foxy in FNAF 1 was quite the fast boy. Foxy is unique in the way that he'll emerge from Pirate's Cove faster or slower depending on how often the player looks at that specific camera. If the player opens the camera too little, he will emerge faster until he has actually left the cove. Once he does, he runs down the West Hall and into the office. However, the scene of him rowing on the camera instantly made its way into FNAF fame since we all started making jokes about him running for that birthday cake. And no, I don't mean the kind with candles, batter, and icing. The Swiggity Swooty coming for that booty meme itself was actually separate to Running Foxy, but the two ended up combining into one of the most iconic memes of all time, at least in FNAF verse fan world thing. And you know what? Recently, that's how I'm reacting if I see that Chica KFC double bucket booty. So I understand you, Foxy. I get you. Or maybe he was just trying to run away from Roxy's toxic ass. In at 4, Exotic Butters. What would you rather get as a bonus? A basket of money or a basket of exotic butters? Obviously, you go with the exotic butters so you have some weight to bash the fan with. The fan. While the fan may be the scariest thing in the game, Exotic Butters has been more of a recognized meme and one that I found more of than the fan. The fact that you can only receive the Exotic Butters is terrifying, and the fact that this has received multiple remixes as well as memes makes me sick to my stomach. But I gotta admit that Margarine Remix is pretty bomb. But why call it Margarine Remix? It's butter and exotic butter, so why not be like the Exotic Margarine Remix? I feel like Exotic Butters is some form of euphemism I'm not understanding, but the fact that a basket of butter was so iconic that it generated multiple remixes and memes and even plushies just confuses me. I don't understand how just a literal basket of butter is doing that. Why do you think a basket of butter was even offered and even insisted upon as a bonus in Sister Location? Like, what? Let me know your theories below. And 3, Halloween Masks. The Halloween masks are now officially canon. I mean, sure, the big kids were wearing them in the end of FNAF 4 when Michael Afton gets bitten and dies, but like, holy ever-loving hell are these things creepy in real life. They were bad in Hell Wanted, especially because if you didn't wear the right one, you died, but still, IRL, these things are GMMSMPIIGTDCBLATUF. Got it in one. And it means, these things are gonna make me shit my pants if I get too damn close, because look at these ugly fricks. But no, seriously, look at them, because the masks just hanging on the rack with like the fabric or rubber head but with the plastic face is terrifying, and I don't understand why the whole thing can't just be rubber or plastic. Like, pick one. Like, the scariest thing about this to me is that these damn things are such a waste of material. Like, sure, the Helpy mask is funny because buff Helpy, but that one was made of all plastic. These are a mixture of both. And I'm sure that other ones are being shown as well, probably ones that make more sense, but they're all creepy. Why would I want to put the face of a character that has a dead child stuffed inside of them on my face? By proxy, that means that I am the dead child who was killed by Afton, who is now suffering for eternity with no damn reason. Also, I've seen a lot of people thinking that Spring Trap and Scrap Trap are different. I need to clear this up, they're not. Pink Guy is Purple Guy, is William Afton, who is Spring Trap, who is Scrap Trap. Why would Spring and Scrap Trap be different? Like, Scrap Trap is a scrap of Spring Trap. Like, Spring Trap didn't die in the fire of Fazbear Fright, and that's why he pops out at the end of what Michael was saying. Not because Michael is Spring Trap, but it was Scott showing us that Spring Trap is still alive. Also, why would Scrap Trap be another person? We've only seen one Springlock Golden Bonnie suit, and it is Spring Trap. And he hadn't been destroyed, so he had to be lured to the Pizzeria Simulator to burn with the rest, and he got sent to the depths of hell. Hence why Henry in the proper ending mentions his old friend. Got it? Good. Hopefully the people who think that are actually watching. Cuz. If not, I just explained myself, and you already know, so I'm sorry. Finally, in at number 1, How to Make It Not Scary. With over 45 million views on part 1, the series of How to Make Five Nights at Freddy's Not Scary is actually pretty scary. The series points out so many different things that we didn't think about because we were too busy trying not to die. Like how everyone was complaining that Chica was a girl, so they made her dummy thick. And then he was talking about cutting off your own face because Justin Bieber said he was taking a break. It's a lot, and the fact that the series has constantly had over 30 million views is something mind-baffling. Nobody's actually used these things to make it seem less scary, and editing is what makes the difference. So if you don't have the right aspects of FNAF, it makes it easy to not be scary. You don't get scared of the game unless you can hear it. I figured that out when I was playing it on the bus, trying to get that girl. Again, still didn't work. Thought I was gonna be cool because I wasn't scared, but no. It just doesn't work if you don't have all the elements, and that's what makes this series the scariest of them all.